the wild, hell-raising girls who ruled MTV in the 80s are all grown up and having babies. They're changing diapers, for God's sakes. First, there was Madonna, and now, hold on to your seats, Cyndi Lauper is a mom. Please welcome the chick who could have written the theme song to this show, Girls Just Want to Have Fun, Cyndi Lauper. Motherhood has tamed you, but...
Yes.
You've toned down a bit.
See?
It happens. It happens with a child. Well, actually, nothing about you is... I mean, you're not subtle. You're out there in everything you do.
I'm very subtle.
Oh, I'm sorry. In your own Cyndi Lauper
way. In my own way.
But yes. I was teasing the audience before about the way your son came into the world. Can you tell the story? Because it is so typical. I mean, I'm not surprised by it.
What do you mean? That we were...
In the cab...
Well, it wasn't a cab. See, it's very hard to call car services when you don't know when you're going to go into labor. And I was hell-bent, I took the whole Bradley thing very seriously because we weren't sure if he had a hole in his heart. You know, they give you so many sonograms that, some kids don't develop the same way. And it's a good thing that they can tell ahead of time. But we thought he had a hole in his heart. Or we weren't sure. And those kind of things aren't that serious because 90% of those things close up at birth. So because of that, I didn't want to be medicated because if I'm 150, which I hate to admit I was.
150 pounds? Oh, that was 180. It's all right.
But it's healthy. It's healthier. Anyway, but.
So you're in the cab.
We got medication. A car service and it had a license plate on it, Diva. And I was,
Stars
screaming.
Car? Okay.
I know, right? I was screaming, and actually, I was in transition, so I had a bucket.
But I know you're screaming. Didn't you have a chicken head on your head?
Well, yeah, that was my hat. I had like a little
Aren't you missing the point of the story? I mean, isn't that all?
I had a snowboard hat on with pigtails and a Betsy Johnson coat. The big furry things and my overalls. And I was screaming, but because you when it hurts, you yell, and I'm loud. So, the guy was a Russian. He was from Russia, and he didn't speak English. And he was driving, and my husband was going. She just saw the phone bill, so, and the guy, because he was making jokes, being nervous, and the guy was driving, going, I had a baby last week. I'm okay. I'm okay. And I'm screaming, don't take 66th Street! We'll never get there!
But everything worked out fine.
Well, I got there just in time.
The baby's fine, Declan's fine.
Oh, Declan, are you kidding? He's great.
He's 9 months now, right?
No, and 2 weeks. And
so what is he teaching you? You said that children provide wisdom to adults. What's he teaching you?
Well, it's always your own issues, right, that you haven't mastered. And then the kid comes, and it's a situation that you have to master to help them, or you don't, and you just continue being dysfunctional. I don't know, whatever it is.
How are you going to explain yourself to him when he gets a little bigger? Because I know with my son, who's 10, all they want is their parents to sort of melt into the woodwork. And he's got now a baby book. Mom has the chicken hat on, right before he's born. I want to show the video of during pregnancy.
We had a tiara.
Oh, you had a tiara. Oh, well.
Because we had party hats because we wanted to make a birthday for him. Because he was entering the world.
Oh, so you have a picture of everybody in tiara? Oh, that's actually very cool.
Well, no, this is a video that I did impromptu.
Okay, well, this is when you were pregnant. Can we just roll that, Mark, the video of you? Because how will you explain this?
This is the Ballad of Cleo and Joe.
That is you with Declan in your tummy.
Without music.
Right, but there, are you painted like a, there you are, a disco ball, right?
Yeah.
In your stomach.
Where's the music?
There you go. Now, what do you...
There's
no
music.
Well, we cut that out so we could talk over it. I mean, what do you say to him?
But that's
when
he loves house music. That was house music. I guess, what do I say?
Yeah, because he's going to
He sings, and I sing, and he likes my hair colorful. In fact, when he could first see color, I dyed my hair red because I wanted him to always see me. And then...
If he said to you when he's 10, though, Mom, he'll never miss you. If he says to you when you're 10, can you tone it down, Mom? Can you have one color hair and maybe, like a simple Chanel whatever and go to the PTA meeting?
I will go to the PTA meeting.
Like this?
I don't know. Okay. It depends on what, you know, what the situation calls for.
Absolutely.
You don't, you know, when in Rome, sometimes you don't want to embarrass him. I don't know what that situation's like because I haven't been there yet. I only know now he is testing his voice. He's very loud.
And he's got a good voice, I heard, so just like Mom.
We were watching the three tenors in Paris. Did you catch that? And he was, every time Pavarotti sang, he did the same phrasing. I must admit, I was crying because I thought, you know.
Another Pavarotti. You played the tin whistle for him, right?
Yes,
so we
I
have
did.
It. Will you play it out, please?
Oh, my
a
God.
A little, just a little, as we
go. Well, you know, my father, my husband, the father, said to me at one point, can you choose a lower key? Because it can be abrasive, and I'm not great at it. So
but this is what you play for Declan.
I played him.
We'll be right back with more of Cyndi Lauper.
I do that a lot for him, but the song will.
Coming up, are your kids stressing? Learn something new Tuesdays on ABC.
And in honor of parents everywhere, isn't that wonderful? It's coming from me. We have to tell you about. I just thought it would be a great thing. We decided to tell you about a dad's dilemma that we heard about down in Alabama, where they take parenting seriously, baby. Take a look at how this father punished his teenage son, who had received several speeding tickets and missed his curfew. Roll the tape, Mr. Director. All right, that's right. He strung up that boy's truck in the tree for the whole world to see. You understand what I'm saying to you? The sign read, this is what happens when a teenager does not mind. That sounds like my grandfather. Mm. Then in smaller letters, the sign said, it may be for sale. So in honor of parents and teens everywhere who have to deal with unusual crimes and punishments, we thought we'd pose this question. What would have been the perfect punishment for you had your parents only known? So Cyndi, we start with you. Had your parents known what would have really gotten to you, how would you have been punished?
Well, Star, I do not believe in punishment because I was sent to a convent for a while and they were so irrational and so strict, but mostly irrational.
But look how nicely it worked out.
I know. You fought the system. That's why we love you.
No, no. My mom was not like that. I grew up watching my mom. And hi, Nana. She's in the hospital, so I figured I'd say hi.
Hi, Nana.
98, three generations.
You better go, Nana.
The thing is, if it says in the Penelope Leach book, because I am reading about this stuff, and there is a book I would suggest that father read, How to Rescue Our Boys from the Myths of Boyhood. You can buy it in the store. It's a very good book, and it's a PhD, did a research about boys in America, and it's important that he learn to communicate and not act irrational because he can't expect his son to act rational.
So you don't really like the punishment that the father did?
If a child misbehaves, it's them trying to tell you something's wrong. If a baby cries, it's because they got to change a diaper or something's wrong. If a child misbehaves, that's their way of telling you something's wrong. You don't, have a sign up? Which one's the bigger kid, dad or the son?
Meredith, you kind of feel a lot like
yeah,
that about punishment,
don't you? I don't have an answer anymore.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's a great answer. No,
I'm
but
sorry.
That puts it in a different perspective.
I really and truly, but unless, you know, it's an advertisement for, you know, parents do the darndest things.
But wouldn't they just misbehave because
because it's adolescence. Like, my teen years, I don't think anything was wrong. I was just out of my mind.
Then something was wrong.
So what could you
I was just wild. Mind.
No, no, something was wrong.
But don't you think it's a certain age? Like, kids between
that
13
too,
and
yes.
18 are just,
well,
like,
maybe,
all bent
maybe
up.
The parents should understand about human development.
I think because they
and
were
stop
so
giving you that sugar. That's what the problem
yeah, is. Yeah, I was one of those children who wasn't allowed to have too much sugar, and I would eat it anyway.
Well, I'll tell you what, they could have really tortured me by having me go spend a weekend with my fascist uncle and reread Mussolini's diaries, because this
yeah.
guy, all he wanted to do was read Mussolini. And so,
what?
Yeah, I had an uncle like that, didn't you?
You know, Bestie's talking in my ear. I can't even focus on what you're saying. Now, like, you thought that I was supposed to read Mussolini's diary.
No, forget it. Go on.
I know, it was a joke that I missed and went, ooh.
On to the next.
What if you give them, like, a taste of their own medicine?
So that's what I think my parents should have done.
Well,
when I used to smoke out of the bathroom window, thinking my parents didn't know. And I think the better punishment would have been for me if they had shut the window and said, you smoked the whole pack in this tiny little bathroom. I think that would have been a good punishment.
You'd have been dead.
Nah. But I probably would have realized how disgusting, you know. And
I'm afraid your lungs may have been black by now.
No, I'm talking about a one-time thing.
No, I agree.
I agree with Cyndi. I was never punished as a child, and I'm fine. Look at me.
No, I was punished so badly.
And see, I was disciplined as a child, and definitely look at me.
Well,
was disciplined.
Exhibit A.
But
exhibit
my discipline
B.
was you can't go to the library, which most kids would have went. Yes.
Oh,
you know what? What am I supposed to do? Lie? You want me to say something?
No, you were.
You
good.
Had another
but
one
look
though.
At how they celebrated you. You're a lovely woman. You have a sparkle in your eye. You're happy, and you know what? That's a reflection on the love and joy that they showed you as a child.
I love her.
I absolutely love
her. Well, my parents showed me love and joy. My parents always showed me love and joy, but I was still punished.
Yeah, but you enjoy it.
I know I do.
You like to give my nice mom a big hard time. You give your mother a hard time, and she's wonderful. We want to thank you very much for being here. There are lots of mom and dad out there who are saying, we like this girl. Maybe we need to go pick up that book you recommended.
Yeah, I'm reading it, and I'm going to also learn, teach him some sign language I have to learn so he can communicate with me before he talks.
Some stuff like that.
Deepak's got a lot to say.
We wish you the best.
Oh, he's great.
When we come back, if you are sick and tired of all the stress, confusion, and